So, hi. How are you guys today? Good? Give a clap for all the speakers just now. It's not easy to be up here. Come on. Clap, 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 clap. So before I start, let me thank TEDx Youth and Meredith Foote for having me here today. Thank you very much, TEDx Youth. And before I start, my name is Adam bin Azrif. I am from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Is anyone here from Kuala Lumpur? Can I see you? Is that you? Hello. Hi. Okay, so before I start, let me just tell you a bit about myself, my background, all right? So I come from a sibling of five. I am the second one in the family, the special one. That's what they call it, the second one. If you're the second one, you should know. If you don't, then you're not special. So since I'm the special one and also the favorite one that my mom tells me and not to tell my brothers. I'm sorry, mom. Where's the live camera? I love you. All right. She tells me that I'm always a special one is because of the troubles that I get myself into and how somehow I just got myself out of it, you know. I've always been the mischievous one, the naughtiest one, the ones with most tricks up his sleeves, the one with most ideas in his head that just wouldn't work, but he does it anyway. That was me as a kid. So as a kid, I was always the famous one in the family. I've always been the one that you hear a lot about in family gatherings, in parties, in housewarmings, not because of anything else, but because my mom and my dad is just shouting behind, Adam, stop! Adam, do not! Run! Don't touch that! Adam, Adam! Yeah, that's how famous I am. So throughout that childhood of mine, I grew up to become more and more mischievous and smarter with what I do, with getting out of trouble. So finding shortcuts to, you know, get my homework done faster, to get all the things done better without me even doing anything. So how I did that is basically by going through high school. That's when I learned you get pocket money from, you know, having lunch and stuff, but instead of using it to eat, you use it to pay your friend to do your homework for you. So that's what I did with my pocket money a lot. So when it comes to homeworks, I always do not know what's going on. And when it comes to school, I've always been the one who always gets in trouble. I get caught smoking. I get caught skipping high school. I get caught doing all the nastiest thing that people wouldn't even be, you know, brave to admit in front of a crowd that they actually are not that good. That is the main problem with people that I think today. So why I'm here today on stage is to tell you what I did about it and what my life is all about. Because you see, after high school, knowing that I'm not good with academics, you think what, I'm just going to sit down and tell myself I'm stupid and not do anything and take drugs? Of course, I did. But you see, it's how you look at it. It's how you look at all those stuff that you do, the mistakes that you made. It's either you take it as a blessing or you just stay in the loop. You think you're a druggie because you're taking drugs. But what if you're taking drugs and you say, oh, so this is how it like? You know, maybe I should drug someone and do business with them so I can, you know, they listen to me. You see, you can do many things like how James Bond does, but you don't because you don't want to. So if you learn how to control certain things and put yourself, you know, for example, if you're in the circle right now, you're doing drugs right here and you take your soul out for a while and go like, oh, is that how I look like? Wow. You'll be able to control anything else in the world. I'm not just talking about drugs or whatever, drinks or whatever. I'm talking about life and experience and problems itself. If you take the time to take yourself out from that problem itself, you're not there anymore. And if you leave it there for a while, it'll just somehow disappear, you know? And then it comes back. If it comes back, you just leave it there because sometimes you just can't do anything about it. You have to understand, that is life. Life doesn't revolve around you. You're not important. No one's important. We're just all the same. Because at the end of the day, I'm not going to talk to you about, oh, how Steve Jobs does this and how this guy does that and how this guy does this. No, I'm going to tell you how important I am, but things still come at me and still happens to me. Problems, achievements, everything else. Although I'm not that important in this world. All right? And let me remind you, after high school, I worked right away. I worked in a farm. I washed goats. I washed cows. I cleaned their, how do you say shit in a nicer way? Yeah, you clean that, you know, and then I did that. And then I worked in a retail store. I folded clothes a lot. And then I got sick of that and then got fired because I come late to work. But although I got fired, I learned that I shouldn't come late to work the next time. So I didn't. You see, you learn from your mistakes. And then after that, I got offered to become a barista at this cafe. How I got the job was as simple as this. I just went to this cafe my friend was working at. I met the boss. And the boss was like, hey, you're cute. I was like, oh, thanks. And then my friend calls me the next day. Hey, Adam, do you want to work at as a barista? My boss thinks you're cute. I'm like, yeah, sure, why not? So after working in that cafe, for about 1 year, I cleaned plates, I cleaned toilets, I cleaned everything that I'm supposed to clean. I cleaned pukes after people coming in after hours being drunk and stuff. You know, I cleaned all that. I did all that stuff for close 2 years. I worked as a normal barista, and then I fell in love with the business. I fell in love with meeting new people. I fell in love with all of that stuff. And then to a point where I felt like I'm stuck because I was still in college and working as a part-timer. So I got offered to become a manager, and you know what? I dropped out of college. I became a manager for a cafe, a small little cafe. My dad, my mom, my dad believed in me. My mom was sad because I quit college. My whole family doubted me and think, oh my God, this is the Adam we know, you know, trying to do all this stuff, thinking he has the best idea in the world. And then this happened. One day I was working at this cafe as a manager. I felt like I was stuck. I thought like there's nothing else to do here. You know, it's so little money. You get like what? How many? 1,200 euro a month. And then I told myself, somehow I managed to tell myself, if I can work so hard from a barista and someone offering me to become a manager, I'm really sure someone can offer me to become a partner or something. So I worked and worked and worked so hard to the point where one day I was sweeping the floor so nicely, and then this person, this regular customer of ours, came and said, hey Adam, have a seat. So I sat down. Before you go crazy and stuff, before you fly off and think that you want to be a barista somewhere else and do some of the stuff, why don't you think about this? I'll give you free 20% share. You handle the company, you work with me, run the shop, it's yours, it's your percentage, and you get a pay every month. So I was like, wow, I'm so young and I got all of this, why not? But you have to take my brother as a interior designer and my dad as a construction. So did it. So we did it. 6 months later, we opened that cafe. It went a boom. It was one of the best cafes in town. 6 months after that, I left that company. And 4 years later, I have 7 restaurants of my own. I own a branding and advertising company. And then now I run a fashion label as well, and I consult certain companies like Porsche on their service and stuff. And yeah, I am also divorced 2 months before I came here. And I am here to tell you not about how to make $1,000 in a week, not to make $1,000 in a month, not to make $1 million in a year. I'm here to tell you, how the hell did I go through all that stuff, all these live dramas, people doubting me, people telling me I'm this, I'm that, and me not being able to do this and that, and then failing in my life, in school, and then, you know, marriage itself, and still be here looking great, giving this talk. That's what I'm about to do. So how I'm going to do that is tell you this. Number one, I had confidence in me all the while. No matter what you say, what you tell me, this is what I have when I was born. I was born with bipolar personality disorder. And every time I wake up, I have to convince myself what I like, what I'm doing, why I do this, why I do that, you know? So every time I do that, I keep telling myself all the best reasons that I can so that, you know, I just go through it. And then number two, how do you get confidence? This is how you get confidence. Can I just get one person on the stage before my speech ends? Anyone on the stage? One person. One person, please, anyone. You see, no one's coming on the stage. Because why? I'm not going to choose. Just come. Just come. Come. So, guys, let me teach you something about confidence and how I wake up and why I think this is very, very helpful. Why are you here on stage, by the way?
Because I like you.
Because you like me. Right, thank you very much. So you get 20 euro for free. Go down. Thank you very much. You see? That is what confidence does to you. You don't have to expect and listen to me what you're going to get at the end of the day. That's what you get for not knowing. You just come up. You just balance out the real stuff, what's going to benefit you and what doesn't. I mean, what's the worst that could happen if you come here on stage? To you, what would happen if you come on stage just now? You don't know, right? Exactly. So why didn't you come? Because you didn't know. But if you knew, would you come? But if you knew, by the time you knew, you're late. She got it first. You get what I mean? Do you get what I mean now, guys? Always make the first move without hesitating if it's more beneficial than how it's not. Why scared? Why be scared? So honestly, guys, that's how I just grab it and think about the problems later. Because why? Because once you know what you're capable of and what you're not, and then you know how much shit you can take. Let me tell you something. So through all that, once you know what you're capable of, that's when you start developing yourself. Once you admit your problems, once you admit your mistakes, and you stand here in front, you know, going to meetings or whatever, doesn't matter what it is. If you stand here in front and you go to meetings with all that confidence that you have and everything, and people tell you otherwise, the thing is, you know what you're talking about. You know, that's when you slowly develop yourself. If you don't know, listen. If you know, keep quiet. You don't have to prove a point because you just found another point. You know, so you'll sound smarter in the next meeting with other people. So use that. Be smart. Don't waste your time proving your point. Don't waste your time trying to be smart than someone else. No matter how smart you think you are, there's always someone smarter than you. That's what you should think about. All right? So from there, I always listen to my dad when he tells me, if you sit in a group, this is what my dad tells me all the time. He's going to laugh on the camera today, right now. So this is what he tells me. If you sit in a group and a full of people and they talk about how it'll hurt or how fast you'll die when you get bit by a cobra, you know, they tell you, oh my God, you know what's going to happen if you get bit by the cobra? You'll die in like a few minutes, man. But when you ask them, wait, have you been bitten by a cobra? No, I have not. And then don't be that person. That's what you don't want to be. Being that person who talks like as if they know. Because at the end of the day, if you get bit by a cobra, although you've watched National Geography, you wouldn't know what to do and you look so stupid. I'll just be laughing. I thought you watched National Geography. Why are you dying, man? You get what I mean? So that's one. And, you know, once you learn to be surrounded by all these people, smarter people, experienced people, older people, not people your age. Why I say not your age? I say older because, yes, age doesn't really matter. But to a certain point, when it comes to experience, life experience, emotions, that matters. Because you know why? My dad has been through all the shit in this world. My dad has gone through a lot. We went through bankruptcy. We went to working in a farm. We went to working doors to doors. But he looks as if he's Johnny Depp. He looks as good as hell. He just smiles and looks normal. But if it was me or you in their position, we would look like crap. Don't you agree? Right? So, after developing yourself, what you should know is learning to accept. Learning to accept yourself. Accept why are you here? Why are you standing here? Why are you this person you are today? Because you know why? Let me tell you something. Before I say anything else about this, I'll remind you, I was all that in my childhood, my primary school, my high school. I lost almost everything. I almost lost my life from a crash a few months back. I lost my wife. I lost my little family in my head. I lost my goal. Well, not my goal. I lost my plans, actually. And I'm only 23 today, and I'm still here standing, talking to you guys about how to get through this stuff, because I'm still in it. And you know what? It's not as bad as it seems, as long as that's how you look at it. Look at it as a life blessing, because all these mistakes that you have and you've made up till today doesn't define who you are. It should be telling you what to do next, because whoever I'm dating next, whoever that I'm going to meet or go out with or marry with next, you know what? She'll be the one chasing me. I won't be the one chasing her, because you know why? I know what to do in the next marriage that I'll get myself into, because I know what didn't work the first time. That's why I got divorced. So in the second marriage that I'll be in, I'll be the best husband I will be. You know, so that's how I like to look at my mistakes and whatever that I got myself into. And with that being said, my friends, I tell you now, it took me a lot to come here. I missed 3 flights. I got into a divorce 2 months before I got here. I crashed my car. By the way, this morning, I slept in front of my rented room because my manager right here left the keys in the room. So we slept in the kitchen. And why I'm here today is tell you how I still look this goddamn fine after all that stuff. And also to all my haters out there, this is what I want to tell people with emotions, with problems that, you know, whenever you keep thinking about your parents or people around you telling you, oh, you should do this, this is best for you. You know what you should be doing? You should be doing yourself. You should be doing what challenges you, what will bring you down to the lowest point of your life until you don't know what to do, because that's when you know you're still alive and you can take that. That is what I believe. And this song is especially for all the haters out there, to all the people who doubted me when I was actually working on myself with all my dramas, all my problems, all the goals that I have in my mind, to all my family who thought, Adam is just Adam. He's going to be this, oh, one guy popular in high school, but, you know, with a badass future. But look at me now. I'm here on stage talking to you guys in Amersfoort, in Netherlands, and this song is for my haters. I'm Mr. Technical Guy. Can you please play my song to Mr. Jacob as well? Where's Mr. Jacob? Mr. Jacob? So this song should remind you that at the end of the day, you just gotta wake up, go through it all. Even though when people are doubting you, that's what they like to think. And what you should know best is yourself. Because at the end of the day, when you go to sleep, when you wake up, when you're talking to yourself, it's you talking to yourself, it's you that you're working yourself for. Thank you very much. This is my pass. See you guys. Thank you, Adam.